Understand, when you start doing what God wants you to do, you're going to need power to be successful in it. You're going to need his injection and his change to show up to cause blessings to happen literally in your life. We must be able to embrace our overflowing blessings literally in unpopular surroundings. I'll always say this to you, because many people love the whole idea of thinking that there's something to being popular. But the whole idea of being popular is that this is the only way you get a chance to be popular, is that something needs to be unpopular about you. Understand, your popularity has to be unpopular to somebody. Somebody got to argue about the essence of who you are. And when somebody threatens the essence of who you are, it gives you a chance then to define yourself in another way, and gives God a chance for us to define who he is in our lives. Don't give attacks the power to strike out your victory. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, don't give attacks the power to strike out your victory. What you need to do when you're under attack is bunker down and then come out fighting. Look at somebody say, come out fighting. Listen, you got too much power to act like a spiritual coward. You got to make sure that you can stand. You got a prayer opportunity. You got a stand-up disposition. You got a faith, imposing faith that can stand against the enemy's areas and attacks in your life. You can thwart what the enemy is trying to do. And no matter how much the enemy tries to convince you to you are too little, what you believe about your future should be big. Look at your neighbor and just tell him, what you believe about your future should be big. Would you help me tell that to three people? Tell them, I got a big future. I'm not worried about what nobody says about me. I got a big future. People may be telling you what you're not going to be, what you're not going to have, what's not going to happen in your life, but you got to tell them, I got a big future. My name is on something big. I don't know exactly all that God is going to do, but I know that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. And since my daddy got control of all of this, I'm talking about our Father, which art in heaven. Since he's got control of all of this, I am not ashamed to clearly note that, listen here, is not by power and not by might, but by his spirit. He's able to take care of everything, because it is through his spirit that I inject the might and the authority of heaven into the realm to bring the blessing that releases the increase. And so be increased, live with large faith, and pursue seeing how big God desires your life to be. Knowing this, that your container should not be small. Look at your neighbor and say, your container should not be small. I hear him in Isaiah 54 saying, enlarge your borders. Somebody here ought to talk to your neighbor and tell him, enlarge your borders. There's some blessings that want to come into your atmosphere. And let me tell you, they're overflowing. You need to have some things that pour out to you that's more than you're able to contain here. Why would he say it in Malachi 3 if he would pour you out a blessing? Why would he tell you in Psalm 23 that you're going to overflow? If you were not going to have an overflow, how dare you come to church with just a little bit you have left and act like that's the end? You got to say, listen here, God shall, my God shall, he shall bless me. He's going to increase my greatness. Did I stop there? And comfort me on every side. Talk to your neighbor and say, I'm all right with the way God is blessing me. Come on. You ought to tell somebody, I'm all right. I'm all right with him making a way. I'm all right with him covering me. Why are you so all right with me with it like that? Because I read the word of God, and all John asked him in the prayer was, give us this day our daily bread. And all my life now, 59 years and almost a month now from 60, all my life now, I got to say that every day he keeps making a way out of no way. Every day he keeps showing up. Every day he makes sure there's some food on my table. Every day he makes sure I got some clothes on my back. Every day he gives me choices. Somebody here ought to thank God for your choices. Everybody don't have the choices you have, but when you have choices operating in your room, you have to look back and say, this is not by mistake. This is just a part of my overflow. I wish there were some folk who were in the overflow, didn't mind giving God a gracious bark in the room right now, because overflow is in your neighborhood, at your house, in your life. You ought to make the devil mad, because the blessings of the Lord make it rich and add no sorrow to it. Y'all excuse me. I just feel like giving God glory, because God has already done everything he said he's going to do. And if he already did what he said he's going to do, then I ought to lose my mind with expectation about what's coming next. Somebody ought to help me talk to your neighbor. Get excited, because the best is still coming. Somebody give him glory, huh? Sit down, y'all. I got to get out of here. When we look at it this way, my God, somebody just holler overflow. No. That's about maybe about 50 or 60 of y'all said overflow. No, I said somebody in the room holler overflow. Somebody who knows that just some stuff can come to you this week, that God can open some doors for you before the day is over, that God can change some situation before we get out of here. My God, somebody holler overflow. Somebody know that you're in a situation that God can turn it around, that God can make it happen for you, that he can bring a blessing out of something that looks like a mess. You ought to join me and just go ahead and holler overflow, overflow. I mean, I'm blessed already, but I'm excited about the overflow. I'm blessed already, but I'm excited about what's on the way. I'm blessed already, but I know overflow is coming. Somebody holler overflow. Sit down, y'all. Just got a few minutes here to mess with this text. My God, hallelujah. Would you prophesy about your own future and tell somebody, my best days are still coming? The devil needs to hear that you ain't giving up. The enemy needs to hear that you ain't ready to quit. My God, your adversary needs to know that, listen, you on the brink of something brand new. Somebody holler, my best days are still coming. Now sit down, y'all, sit down. My God, my God, my God, my God, my God. My God. You can shake somebody's hand and say, it's coming, it's coming. My dreams are going to come true. My anticipation is going to become my reality. New doors are going to open. New ways are going to be made. My God, look at somebody and say, you must not know who I serve. You must not know what he's able to do. The cattle of a thousand hills belong to him. God, he's able to do anything. At the end of the day, he's the first and last. He's the author and the finisher of my faith. Tell somebody, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. So now, y'all, I got to get out of here. Now, your present condition is not constructed or designed to hold the future that your life is trying.